I was working for Oman International Bank, and one Mr. Asit Mehta from the Nuclear Securities Limited, he happens to be our client in Bombay. He asked me whether, can you do something? I also thought that there is no opportunity there. Prior to that, you know, Heroes Pambros, Thomas Cook, RRC, and one more company was there from Calcutta. There were four or five companies. And at that time, the quantum of formation was only 250 NTS and $500 FTS. That was the thing. I asked him whether I was serious about this business, because only $500 we can give, how much you will earn? He says, days will change, you know, and the new things will come. Let us see what will happen in the future. But it is not the only side, because I was heading all their financial products, merchant banking, and we started the foreign exchange through Foreign Exchange Dealer Association, FEDAI. We got the Forex broking license, and I was managing broking license also, and merchant banking, and then corporate finance. All activities there, but you know, foreign exchange also started. But you will be surprised, within 7 years, we have opened about 27 branches across the country. And that's how it started. But then Reserve Bank also realized, and they started giving the license to everyone. Unfortunately, there is no level playing field. If somebody invests 25 lakhs, he will get the license. That is the condition. They don't see what is your background and kind of things. The person who invested 25 lakhs as a capital, he will buy a flat of 25 lakhs. His desire is over, but the business will continue, whether money is there or not there. That was the situation. And we represented RBI also to increase that, but it has not happened. Anyhow, it created a lot of opportunity for the people to start the business. Lot of employments are created. But at the same time, it's very unfair to the government or the Reserve Bank of India, given the opportunity. We should have conducted the business in the way it is expected to do it. Because it is all regulated business. We don't have authority to cross the RBI guidelines. But then what is happening is, we are very clever in maneuvering, manipulating, and then taking the advantage. So, and interpreting in our own way. That is what has happened, and then business is continued. But there are some companies who stood by the principle, we could not make money. We are running the business, we have expanded the business. Today also, we started Star Global 7 years back. And in Hyderabad, I think Arun was the first manager here for us. We never cross our boundary. We know for sure. See, in this business, there are only two major risks. One is regulatory risk, second is credit risk. Okay, now regulatory risk, we cannot afford to take any single chance. Because each Reserve Bank of India regional offices, they have their own guidelines, how to go and how to inspect. The single branch, money branches, they go once in 1 year or 2 years. For the branches with multiple locations, or AD2, they visit regularly. And then it becomes so, sometimes we feel that what kind of, you know, punishment is this? Because they go so deep and ask such a question, and we will not be able to answer also. But then we look at the other side, what is happening in the market, it is happening totally different. But now that is also fine, because we are regulated. Credit risk is another risk, which everybody has burned the finger in one or the other time, including us. It is not the however intelligent you may be. You don't know how the other side is there, and how will it come and how will we cheat you. So these are all happening. In our non-personal kind of things, they are all happening. The credit risk is basically our domain. Now we can take a risk, so money gone, 5 crores gone. But the regulatory risk, it will cost you your license. And there are instances where many of the licenses have been cancelled by Reserve Bank of India across the country. Not only here, not only, you know, Bangalore or Karnataka. Everywhere, you know, it is happening. But then we should be very careful. As an employee, as an owner, there is a difference. Employee, you see, we are giving him the target. He wants to fulfill the target. He do whatever he wants. Anyway, he has to complete. But the owner has to see whether we know this is the right way of doing the business and then do it. So we take care of that. So in our company, I'm not saying we are all perfect. And I don't say today also that even though we tell them to do the business, whether they are doing in the same manner. But what is the principle is basically, credit risk, I can take a risk. You tell me if anything happened, we can say, mistake as you do. But regulatory risk is concerned, please, for God's sake, don't cross your boundary. You must understand your limitations and see how you will do the business. And then only we can survive. I just tell you, for your guide information, when the COVID was there, COVID started, And that time, we are the part of the Wirecard Germany. Wirecard is one of the largest fintech company in the world, and it is the 30th DSF company from the Germany, listed company. But suddenly in the June 20th, they declared insolvency. When they declared insolvency, believe me, our company has no parents, no shareholders. Banks, next day morning, banks have withdrawn entire facility of 50 crores. They have withdrawn. So I have to run the business now. Business was, luckily for us, business was slow because COVID was there, nobody was traveling. So I have to take a decision what to do. I run for at least 2-3 months. Then I requested all the employees to take some cut in the salary, not for all those who are there, but that is maximum 40% cut. But only one thing we did, we never closed down any branches nor retrenched any employee. If the employee on his own wanted to go, we have not stopped it. But we have not retrenched any employee and continue to pay the salary. And today, because we stayed in the business, we sustained that time, RBI has issued 3 times show cause notice to me. Because my NOF has come down below 10. We are 82, our NOF has come down. I requested RBI, the negotiation is going on, investors are coming, but because of COVID, you know, we can't meet, we can't talk. So it may take some time. And they are very, very considerate. They consider this thing, and finally the result is today, NUMPT Singapore took over us. The day they took over, not only we have restored the salary for all the employees, we gave the 10% increment for all the things they have done. They stayed with us, and today that company is continuing. Boss, today what is happening in the market, fintech is taking a place. The banks are also feeling the threat. Today you see Google Pay, Phone Pay, they are doing about 85% of the transaction, retail transaction in the market compared to the bank. So digitalization is happening. Reserve Bank is giving more importance to digitalization. Government is, you know, giving importance to digitalization, central government basically. So going forward, definitely the industry will be there. Industry cannot be, you know, we cannot write off this industry. This industry will be there, but only thing is the fittest is survival. Who will do the right business, they will survive. Otherwise, regulatory authorities, you take anything. They are very, very serious about the investigation. It may take 4 years, 5 years, 6 years. But they will come to the doors and ask for the questions. Recently, something happened in Chandigarh. We received the notice from there, from Chandigarh FERA, ED. These are the names. If you have done any business for last 6 years, give all the details. Now, we have to do. We cannot hide anything. We have to do and we give. Whatever transition we have done, we give. So, that is the way. So, Reserve Bank is also very considering. But friends, let us not forget. We should not lose our moral compass. And we should know what the company is supposed to standing for. Company is established for doing the right business. Therefore, when it comes to the principle, stand like a rock. Don't wave. Don't swim with the current, this thing. Because if somebody is doing, I also do, it is not the way. If somebody is doing, let them do it. But what you are expected to do, what you are supposed to do, you do that. Then only we will survive. Today, this company, when the NUM took over, it is not an exaggeration kind of thing. They checked the market, entire market, with the leaders, with the bankers. Even though the company is under loss, our capital was written up to the extent of 6 crores. 1 year itself of my loss was 4.5 crores because I was paying salary, no business. But then they took over our company. And they are hopeful of, you know, developing it because they are coming with their own card and things. So it will work. So my request to all of you is business, there is an opportunity for everyone. Market is very large. It is like an ocean. How much big you can, you know, vessel you take, you bring that kind of water. But do a right way of business without, you know, cutting the corners. There are certain things we can bend. Suppose today he is not able to give the ticket copy, tomorrow you take it. But it is not that without ticket, without password, you are receiving for it. It is not done. Thank you very much.
Sir, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your valuable suggestion. Sir, one question to you. What is your suggestions and advice?
Let this new or old, the business principle is the same. Because it is a regulated business. You cannot say, see, new Balkan, we are talking about the change. Sun is not rising in the west, sun is rising in the east only. The fact, the principle remains the same. We cannot afford to change the principle. Unless RBI changes. See, today you remember, earlier, whenever you go to the corporate, they said they wanted the bold resolution for this. So, subsequently, they also realized it is not feasible, they removed it. Earlier, the endorsement on the passport was there. They have removed. So many things are happening. So they will also change it. See, but we can't jump that. We have to wait with the patience. Patience does not mean that you are not doing anything. Patience means you are waiting for an opportunity time to do the business. It will come. We will be, everybody will prosper. Everybody will prosper. Everybody has got their own wish. Depend upon their limitation and the capacity.
With your team, the pillars of FEMTA here, why don't you have in a small association? You have your own sharing of information about the RBI guidelines, recent changes, how to play in the market. There is in a commercial banks, we have see the various organizations, see that with the regulatory bodies and they have the legal perspective. But why don't you have a common platform like then you say that we drafted when small, he himself is drafted in a small thing and come back, we have come back within a small articles of association, etc. The primary intention of the FEMTA is that common platform to the market, take the RBI guidelines to the root of the root, small thing, Armenia, small things say that from Anantapur, small thing. You have to reach to them. They have to reach to the common man. Then our deputy governor, then Mr. H.R. Khan is there. He told that we used to tell about in various forums then. Foreign exchange no more in a foreign. It is within us. It is a every family, in every person in every family has gone in abroad. Either you have in a foreign exchange. These medium, these FFMC should reach to the those person in the family to exchange it. They should not be allowed to go for in a grey market. That is a very dangerous thing for the economy and to the regulators. This is a background in which that we experience the FEMTA. You reach to the people and go to the common area and apply for a Reserve Bank for a license. They will give you. They are very magnanimous in giving license to that. When you give the license, you read your license conditions, etc. You do the business for initially 3 years, etc. Then. The thing is that small economy and is always in a good small economy. You see that when small is beautiful, when German economies say that no, only small economies only will lead to in a greater economy. This has become, you are the small players. It's not mean that you are the root of the economy. It's not say that when you are doing in a 25 lakhs is a one common capital that you have to go for in a license. I advocated a number of times in within our group that we should bring it back. And LLPs also should come back to this fold, doing this kind of business and reaching to the common man. This idea. What our Bhatt sir was telling about that it has seen number of changes. It has given in that. One in 2005, I think so, G. Padmanabhan sir, small committee was there to have all these kind of changes to happen. But it was, even though that was stringent, but RBI has taken a very liberalized approach giving in a license renewal to the FFMC. Very liberal. If you go to the across the country, Singapore getting in a license is very difficult. Money changing is very difficult. In Dubai, even though it is a liberal economy, and see that it is very stringent laws, but only the India in which that in Reserve Bank has taken a forward perspective that licenses should be given very liberal and do the business. Regarding see that we have seen ups and downs in the FFMCs by the technology side, recently we have seen the COVID period. I used to remember one quote of Martin Luther King. When he has addressed his students in a small class, when you could not able to fly, you walk. When you could not able to walk, then you should crawl. When you could not able to crawl, you just make a movement that you are survived. Now the FFMCs are now in a, earlier in COVID period, and they are doing a small crawling movement site that we are survived. And I've seen, I was told that number of families have suffered because of business. But like people, companies are very few companies ideally see that they have paid salaries to the post-recovery of the COVID and the back. But all FFMCs have not done. Now it is in a recovery mode. And what Martin Luther King says that, and again, all days are not same. we will overcome one day. That now you are in the stage of overcoming and regrouping over yourselves and go forward. My sincere advice to you that you do the business to the profit of your company and within the frame guidelines, what Bud said, that complying with the regulatory perspective. All good luck to you all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Digitalization of the KYCs and everything. If now the present scenario, new FFMs is, how can we sustain it? Or it is better for our community?
See that in, we have to go with the legislation. PMLA 2002 and official records and rule says that you have a digitalization, CKYC, etc. That was the mandatory. You see that we have to change with the perspective of the government of India. Money laundering is the top subject for anything. You may see the 2A tomorrow, everything, anything is there, money laundering side. I used to say that when the eKYC, etc., even Aadhaar card, Aadhaar enabled, 2019 amendment rules are there in PMLA. That even though it is a forward side, but you please comply. We are for the nation. It is a small issue, eKYC, etc. You register it, nothing goes wrong in that. But in overall side, it helps us. Now today with the COVID digital certificate, we are keeping in our pocket. Whenever anybody asks that, we are giving, let us have my KYC. It is my other, my right. My KYC is my right to show and exhibit it. I think it is a rights perspective. You please comply this.
I made a policy and I made up in my mind that I don't want to work for any company. I didn't want to work for any company. Then I first met Mr. Parag of LKP. I spoke to him and I said that I want to give a business to you as a freelancer. I was the first freelancer in India where I was doing business and giving business to LKP. 1997, 1998, 1999, I was crossing the commission of 1,20,000 rupees to 1,50,000 rupees from the LKP. The way I worked in such a focus and my acumenship in my business was very much passionate to me to do all these things. And thanks to Mr. Parag, thanks to LKP, thanks to Zuhari for some time, Zuhari helped me. And thanks to all my friends who could help me to stand on this dais to speak and to introduce myself as Abhinash and being I'm in this industry for 27 years odd. And thanks to jury who selected me or elected me as a 25 years, I mean, I didn't even know that, you know, somebody will really honor me being a crossed quarter century in this trade. But thanks to FEMTA committee, thanks to the jury, thanks to president, chairman and all the people, those really honor me today. And I would like to say only one thing to the people, that you should have that passion to work for your association. And you feel pride to be an association member. And this has been started in 2015 actually. But 2015 was only, we were only discussing about the association along with Mr. Fani and other things. Unfortunately, Fani is not here. I'm really missing him. And we just began in 2015 and when we started these things and people came with the positive and the negative suggestions also. They said, Abhinash, it may be difficult for you to run this association for a long time. Being it's a very small fraternity and people have their own businesses, they don't spend time for their associations also. I could witness earlier, I mean very earlier, I could witness that people were really not interested to come and join the association. But slowly, one and a half year, the way we worked, the way we started financially sound by making all the equities and all that, they had immense faith on us that the association is very serious and a financially disciplined association. But exactly, I feel very halcyon and I was very happy that people could come voluntarily and join this association. Some people joined as a company, some people joined as an individual. And because of hard work of all the people, right from the day one, this credit goes to everybody who could work for this association. Still, I say that the existing committee also working very, very hard and they are doing excellent job. This kind of function, I did not do when I was a chairman or a president. I was very stingy. You can say parsimony. I did not spend much money on this. But first time we could spend because of their dareness, their audacious their confidence to spend the money and the collect of the advertisements and all that, they could get better advertisement money than the expenses. It could overcome the expenses also. So I really appreciate them the way they could do that. And I would say Praveen, Arun, and all the whole team was really doing good. In future also, I think this team will do better. The new team is coming now. And the election has been now contesting. And I request everybody to exercise your vote and get the better people to work for your association. And otherwise, the association will slowly, slowly, slowly get into a kind of a shackle. And we cannot recover at that time. So please beware what association is doing. You have every right to question association. You have every right to understand association. Be humble and be respectable the way you speak, the way you perform, and try to support the association financially, not only financially, morally also. Morally also, you should support an association. Otherwise, the association people get really, they feel that, you know, degenerated. So I express my thanks to everybody. Special thanks to all these two invitees where the guests came to me. I'm really thrilled. And I'm thank you so much to Mr. Naim also, who honored me. I did not expect that Naim would come. Thank you so much. Thank you so much to you all. Thank you. Thank you.
They have honored me with this unique shawl and the certificate. I'm really honored, and also honored that my wife was invited to this, and she also has been honored. Thank you. Thank you so much.